ओके ए वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू माय चैनल मैथ्स विद महंती सर चिल्ड्रेन। इन द लास्ट क्लास वी वर डिस्कसिंग प्रॉब्लम्स ऑफ इंटीजर ऑफ द चैप्टर क्यूब एंड क्यूब रूट, एंड टुवर्ड्स द एंड ऑफ द चैप्टर देर आर सम क्वेश्चन गिवन अंडर द सेक्शन हॉट्स एंड एनरिचमेंट। देर आर सम हॉट्स मीन्स हायर ऑर्डर थिंकिंग स्किल्स, एंड सम एनरिचमेंट क्वेश्चन आर देयर वेयर चिल्ड्रेन जनरली अप्लाई देयर डीपर अंडरस्टैंडिंग व्हाट दे अंडरस्टूड फ्रॉम द लेसन। Bit critical questions are given in this section, that is HOTS and enrichment. Let us solve those questions today, okay? So in the first question, you see I have written here, evaluate cube root of 288 into, there is no sign here, into cube root of 72 into cube root of your 27. How to solve this type of question? What is the rule? You see, now here is one cube root, here is one cube root, here is another cube root, there are three cube roots here. Like we remove brackets, children, go back to class 5 where you had read how to simplify numerical expressions involving brackets of division, multiplication, addition and subtraction. Recall the rule, it was Dimas rule, division, multiplication, addition and subtraction, or Bodmas rule, bracket of, you know all these things, okay. And children, while we remove, you must have remembered that when we remove bracket, we remove the inner bracket first, not the outer. Similar is the case. So here first we have to remove the inner square root. See, this is the inner cube root. So here 27, the cube root of 27 you find out first. Cube root of 27 is 3. See, 27 is a perfect cube, its cube root is 3. Look at 72 is not a perfect cube, but when 3 is multiplied by 72, it became 216, which is now a perfect cube, and its cube root is 6. So what I mean to say, children, first you find the cube root of 27, it will be 3, then 3 will be multiplied by 72, in the next step it will become 216, is a perfect cube. Cube root of 216 is a perfect cube, so find the cube root, it is 6, then multiply 6 by 200. You see, 288 is not a perfect cube, but when 6 is multiplied, it will become 1728, which is no doubt a perfect cube. You can find its cube root by prime factorization method, it will be 12. So the final value will be 12, okay. Now see, three numbers are in the ratio 2:3:4. Look at the next question. There are three numbers given, but we do not know what are the numbers. The ratio is given, you see. Ratio of three numbers is what? 2:3:4. See, ratio of three numbers is given 2:3:4. That means what are the three numbers, we do not know, their ratio is given. So it is 2:3:4, so let it be 2x:3x:4x, okay. Now what is the question? The sum of their cubes, you see, sum of their cubes equal to how much given? 33957, okay. 33957, 33,957, it is the sum of their cubes. Sum of their cubes means sum of the cubes of these three numbers, okay. So now we have to find the cubes of the three numbers. Now see, cubes of three numbers, first you find out what will be the cubes of three numbers. It will be 2x whole cube, then 3x whole cube, then 4x whole cube. So what will be it? It will be 8x cube, 27x cube, and it will be 64x cube. You see, these are the cubes of the three numbers, okay. As the ratio was given 2:3:4, we took it 2x. Children, please remember one thing. Whenever any question you find on ratio, not only in this chapter, in any other chapter, wherever you find a question given in ratio 2:3, then you always take 2x:3x. Where x is to be found out, x is some unknown whose value is to be found out later, and after finding the value of x, if you multiply by 2, you will get the value of 2x, if you multiply 3 by 3, you will get the value of 3x, like this, okay. So these are the cubes of the three numbers. Now what is the sum? Find out according to question. Sum of their cubes, that means 8x cube plus 27x cube plus 64x cube. Okay, equal to how much? It is 33957. This is given according to question. Now you add this 8 plus 7, 15, 9, 8, 7, 15 plus 4, 19, 1, 7, 2, 9. You see, 99. 99x cube will be 33957. So you first find x cube. So x cube will be 33957 divided by 99. Such a big expression. See, we have to, if you divide it will take lot of time. Okay. So I think do by cancellation. Cut it by 11. It will be 9. Cut it by 11. Cancel it by 11. 11, 3 is 33. Then your, this is 0. Then 9. 9, this is 5, 95. 11, 8 is 88. 11, 8 is 88, 7. Yes. It will be 3087. See, 3087 divided by 9. Now you can easily divide. 9, 3 is 27, 3. 9, 4. 36, 2, yes, we got the value of x cube. See, x cube is 343. So we can now easily find what is x. It will be cube root of 343. X will be cube root of 343 because x cube is 343. Okay. And what is the answer? You know what is the cube root? Cube root of 343 is 7. So we got the value of x. Now you put here, here, and here. So that you will get the three numbers. Therefore, the numbers are 2x. 2x means 2 into what? 7, 3x. 3 into 7 and 4 into 7. That is 14, 21 and 28. You see. So the three numbers, this was the question, find the three numbers, okay. So the three numbers will be 14, 21 and 28, whose ratio is 2 is to 3 is to 4. And the, if you find the sum of the cubes, you see, if you find the sum of the cubes of these three numbers, it will be definitely equal to 33957, 33957, 33,957, okay. Now, let us discuss your enrichment questions, okay. Now, what are the enrichment questions given in this section? Let us see. These are the two hot questions given which I discussed. Now let me discuss the enrichment question. It is also very easy. See, enrichment question, what is the question? Find the cube root by estimation. See, find the cube root by estimation. 474, it is a very big number. 474164741632. You see. 4741632. See, children, such a big number, 7-digit number, 33. Yes, it is a 7-digit number. How to find its cube root by estimation? What is the process? Estimation, let us recall the estimation process. This is group 1, this is group 2, this is group 1, this is group 2, and this is third. Okay, now what is the ones place of? Take the cube of 2, it will be 8. So, your ones place of cube root, ones place of cube root will be 8. Ones place of cube root will be 8. 2 cube is 8. So this 2 is the ones place of the first group. Take its cube. We have already discussed. We know. We have done so many problems. So take the ones place of the, take the cube of the ones place of the first group. It is 8. So 8 will be the cube root of ones place of the cube root. Now what is the second group? See, the second group is your which one? 632. 741. You see, group 2. Group 2 is your 741. Now what is the tens place? You see, what is the tens place here? The tens place is 4. Underline the tens place. Now find the we wanted to find here, you see, here we wanted to find the ones place of the cube root. That is why we took ones place of the first group and then took its cube to get the ones place of the cube root. In a similar manner, since you want to find the tens place, see, take the tens place of the second group, which is what? 4. Now take the cube of 4. What will be the cube of 4? It will be 64. And what is the tens place? See, group 2 is 741. Underline the tens place. Now the tens place is 4. Take the cube of 4. It is 64. Now underline the tens place. Which is the tens place? It is 6. So 6 will be the tens place of the cube root. Tens place of the desired cube root. That means the cube root which you want to find, its tens place will be definitely 6 by estimation. Okay. So therefore, tens place of cube root will be 6. Now, how to get the 100 place? Look at the third group is only 4. Now, 4 lies between which two nearest perfect cube? 4 lies between which two nearest perfect cube? Definitely 1 and 8. Okay, because 4 is less than 8 and greater than 1. See. So 4 is less than 8 and greater than 1. That means it is 1 cube less than 4, greater than less than 2 cube. So definitely this 1 will be the 100 place. So because 1 and between 1 and 2, 1 is smaller. So 100th place of cube root will be 1. So you see, 100th place is 1, 10th place is 6, and 1st place is 8. So what will be the cube root? Imagine yourself. 168. This is the method how to find cube root of 7 digit number. You can find the cube root of any digit number in this manner following the estimation method, provided the number is a perfect cube. Okay, so what will be our conclusion? Therefore, cube root of 4741632 will be 168. Okay, so this is how to do number 1. Now let us see the last number, number 2. What is the question? Find the volume of a cube. Children, you know what is the formula for volume of a cube? You have been reading from class 4. Cube is a 3D solid, 3 dimensional solid having length, breadth and height. All are same, known as edge. Volume of cube is how to find out? Edge into edge. Or edge cube you can say. Edge cube, okay. Volume of a cube is given. Find the volume of a cube. We have to find the volume of the cube. It is question. Whose surface area is 150 meters square? Yes. Now, what is surface area of a cube? Have you remembered the formula? Surface area, see children. We know that in a cube, there are 6 faces or 6 surfaces. I need not draw the figure of a cube. See, this is a cube. Okay. It has 6 faces or 6 surfaces and all are plane surfaces. You know that. Okay, so each face is a square. Now there are 6 faces. Other than the base and the top, the rest 4 faces are what? Lateral faces. When both the faces or top and base are added, it becomes the total surface or total surface area of the cube. What is the formula? Anyone was remember? It is 6 into what? Edge square, the formula. There are 6 faces, each face is a square. There are 6 plane surfaces. Each plane surface is a square in a cube. And the square area is what? Side square. So as there are 6 faces, so 6 into edge square. Okay, that will be the formula for total surface area of a cube. Okay, so by surface area it is always meant. You see, in any question, whenever you are given surface area, you will come to understand that it is total surface area. See, so how to do? So total surface area of cube equal to given how much? 150 meter square. So what is the formula now? Therefore, you apply the formula 6 into L square equal to 150. What is L? Where L is edge, where L equal to your edge. It is the edge of cube. Okay. So you see 6 L square is 150. Now you find L square. L square is 150 by 6. It will be 25. So what will be L edge? You find out square root of 25. It is 5 meter. See. So if the total surface area of cube is 150 meter square, then its edge will be 5. We have to find the edge, because without finding edge we cannot find the volume. We are asked to find the volume of the cube, and to find the volume of cube we need the edge. Now we got the edge, and then you apply the formula for finding volume. Just I told you what is the formula. Volume of cube is what? Your edge cube. Therefore volume of cube equal to L cube. L cube means it is, what is the L? L is 5, edge of cube is 5, so it is 5 cube, which is 125 meter cube. Okay. So children, with this I hope you understood this problem, all the problems what I discussed on your HOTS and enrichment. All the HOTS and enrichment questions whatever given in your book regarding cube and cube root, in these problems particularly we found the application of cube and cube root, okay, in this section, that is HOTS and enrichment. And I hope whatever I discussed you understood, children. If it is really so, then I must say that you please hit the like button and subscribe my channel, so that I'll be happy and encouraged to discuss more and more thing again in my upcoming classes or videos. Okay, so children, with this we came to the end of the chapter, I mean total discussion of exercise questions of the chapter cube and cube root. Okay, we shall discuss the exercise questions of the next chapter, that is your exponent and radical, in the next class. I hope children you must have understood. If you think yes, what Manti sir is explaining we are able to understand very nicely, then children I must say that you please hit the like button and subscribe my channel. Okay, thank you.